Hello everyone. In this video we'll be seeing about module 3 tool life. So in the previous video we saw about what is tool wear. Tool wear means failure of the cutting tool, and tool life, how long the tool withstands. So the tool life, it tells about how long a tool can perform very well in a machining operation. So every device or a tool has its functional life, at the expiry of which it may function but not efficiently. So it is also true that with a cutting tool, during use the tool loses its material, that is it gets worn out. As the wear increases, the tool loses its efficiency. So its life has to be defined, and on expiry of its life it should be reground for fresh use. Without regrounding we cannot use a tool for a next operation once its life has gone. If we are continuing without doing the reground, the obtained components will not be of a good surface finish, or it will not be a usable one. It will be going to the scrap only. So the tool life is considered to be the most important factor for a tool. So the tool life is the duration of actual cutting time after which the tool is no longer usable. There are many ways of defining the tool life, and the common way of quantifying the end of a tool life is by limit on the maximum acceptable flank wear. So when the flank wear is increased, then it is said that the tool is not fit to continue the operation, so it has to be reground. So similar to our life, once we will be continuously working, once our time comes, entire life is getting wasted, and like that for the tool also. One, it can work to some time only. So how human are having a retirement age of 60, after that they can work, but not up to a as they were doing before 60. So like that the tool also, it has a certain limit, so after which it cannot work, but human cannot be regrounded to do to work again. But this tools, it can be regrounded and it can be used. So we can see about what are the how the tool life is defined on different ways. So the time elapsed between two successive grindings. So how we can define that the tool is stopped working, tool is not working properly. So while doing a machining, the timing between completing a component, so when it is used as a first time, the timing will be of very short, but when it keeps on increasing, the timing, it starts increasing and the component will not be of a better surface finish. And the second one, period during which the tool cuts satisfactory, and the total time accumulated before tool failure occurs. Tool life is expressed in minutes. So these are the three factors that can be defined in these are the ways that a tool life can be defined. And the next one is factors affecting the tool life. So the factors affecting the tool life, it plays a very important role. One is cutting speed, second one is feed and depth of cut, third one is hardness of a workpiece and microstructure of a workpiece along with the tool material. So these are some of the factors that are affecting the tool life. And in a continuation of the same, here is also some other factors that also affect the tool life. One is tool geometry, the next one is type of cutting fluid and its method of application, and the next one is nature of cutting, grind size of the workpiece, rigidity of a workpiece machine tool system. And the next one is Taylor's tool life equation. So he is an American engineer who developed a standardized test to determine the relationship between cutting speed and time, so that it remains useful for the tool. So in a Taylor's tool life equation, he has given an equation as Vt par n is equal to c, where v is nothing but velocity of the cutting tool, which is expressed in meter per minute, and t is nothing but tool life, which is expressed in minutes, and c and n are the Taylor's coefficient of all the variables like feed, speed and depth of cut, type of workpiece material, etc. the factors that affecting the tool life were, one is the cutting speed. So that is the most important factor that is affecting the tool life. So this Taylor, an American engineer, he developed a standardized test to determine the relationship between cutting speed and time the tool remains useful. So the test was carried out in different combinations of tool and workpiece material, and the flank wear of the tool, and the test was measured. It was found that practical amount of wear to measure the before breakage was 0.75 mm for a solid and brazed tips and 1.25 mm for ceramic tools. The test was carried out to determine the time taken to reach this amount at various cutting speed, and this is the plot that is obtained as a result of the plotting the graph between cutting speed and the tool life. So these are some of the materials for which the values of N is given. For high speed steel, the value of N stands between 0.1 to 0.18. For an uncoated tungsten carbide, it ranges from 0.2 to 0.25. For a TIC or a TIN coated tools, it is of 0.3. And for a Al2O3 coated WC tools, it is of 0.4, and for a ceramic tools, it is of 0.4 to 0.7. So these are some of the values of N for the tool materials. And next is about effect of cutting parameters on tool life. So for all metal cutting operations, cutting speed, feed, depth of cut form the critical parameters because they affect the productivity of the machining operation. Surface finish, heat generated during cutting, power consumption, and particular life of the cutting tool. So the first one is cutting speed. So cutting parameter, so cutting speed, feed, depth are the three cutting parameters that are considered for a machining operation. So first let us look about how the cutting speed, it affects the tool life. So it refers to relative surface between tool and the workpiece. So the tool varies inversely as a cutting speed. As the cutting speed increases, wear rate increases. So cutting speed, it plays a very major role in the affecting the tool life. So if the cutting speed is increased, wear is also increased. So the same wear criterion is reached in less time, and it is achieved in a very less time also. So the tool life decreases with the increasing cutting speed. So this is this plot, it shows you the variation effect of a speed on a tool life. And the next one is about the feed. So feed is the amount of material removed for each revolution or per pass of the tool over the workpiece. Increasing feed rate increases cutting temperature and flank, thereby shortening the life of cutting tool. So on the whole, feed is also not a good parameter for a tool to maintain its life. So if the feed is increased, the temperature increases and it is shortening the life of the cutting tool. And the next one is depth of cut. So depth of cut, it relates to depth of cutting edge of the tool engages the work. Small depth of cut results in friction when cutting the hardened layer of work tool, which results in wear. So if you are increasing the depth of cut, if you are increasing the depth of cut, it will increase the tool life over an increase in feed rate. So of the three parameters, depth of cut is considered to be the most satisfiable fact parameter, which saves the, if the depth of cut is increased, it saves the tool life, that is tool life is increased. So the next one is machinability. machinability in a ease with which a metal can be cut, permitting the removal of the material with a satisfactory finish at a low cost. Materials with good machinability, that is free machining materials, require little power to cut, which can be cut quickly, easily obtain a good surface finish and do not wear the tooling much. The factors that typically improve a material's performance often degrade its machinability. Therefore, to manufacture components economically, engineers are challenged to find a ways to improve the machinability without harming performance. So the next one is various factors on which the machinability depends. So the machinability, it depends on various factors, like the first one, physical properties of a work materials like tensile strength, hardness, etc. More the strength, more the difficult to cut. Second one is chemical composition of a workpiece material. Addition of lead and sulfur, it improves the machinability. And the third one is microstructure of a work material. For example, the arrangement of atoms of a work material. Cutting conditions like tool geometry, use of cutting fluid, selecting parameters. And the fifth one is rigidity of a tool and work holding devices indirectly affects machinability. So these are some of the factors on which the machinability is depend on. And the next one is machinability index. So machinability index, it's nothing but the ratio of cutting speed of a material for 20 minute tool life to the cutting speed of free cutting steel for 20 minute tool life and into 100. So this is how the machinability index percentage is calculated. This is the formula used for the machinability index. So this is about machinability index and the tool life. Thank you.